Hello students, today we will discuss the topic Society and Culture. Man and its evolutionary history have given us a chance to understand the concept of society and culture. Mankind has experienced various stages of development, which is well explained in the developmental history in the form of various stages along with the development of technologies. In this process of adaptation and evolution, man creates his society and culture through various network relationships and process, linking it with different stages of development socially and culturally, paving a way for the continuity of mankind. Let us try to understand the conceptualization of the term society and culture. The concept of culture provides a long-term network of relationships between individuals of a society. And when we use the term society, it always consists of various socio-cultural systems, roles and regulations, institutions that remain the backbone of man's existence. Men develop unity and solidarity through the process of learning and teaching. In other words, the knowledge which are transferred from one generation to other by the process of socialization and social organization paved the way for attaining such solidarity and unity among the members of the society or societies. To understand details of it, there is a need to understand man and its society, which can be understood through the analysis of culture and its relationship among the individual members of the society. Many scholars have given the definitions of society in different ways. Some of them are McIver and Page. The sociologist in 1950 defined society as a web of relations, a complex system of usages and procedures of authority and mutual aid of many groupings and divisions of control of human behavior and of liberties. According to Durkheim, the sociologist defined it as the combination of social facts and values, a sense of collective consciousness for social integration. The definition of society provides the importance of the role relationships among the members of society, which in turn provides the intricate relationships expressed in different ways based on the position as well as capabilities of the individual members. However, understanding such relationship is not a simple way. Instead, it is considered as rather difficult and complicated in terms of its function as well as applicability. The assigned role relationships and responsibilities are meaningful when it meets the required expectation from each member of the society. These relationships are always considered and accepted in a very systematic way, and we as an individual cannot stand or exist unless we become part of this larger group, or what we call members of the society. Now, what are the main components of society? Is it only the individual members present in it or anything other than this. There are patterns and behaviors to be followed in a society. These remain the part and parcel of what we call the learned behavior or culture, which keeps on transferring from one generation to another. Before we take up the term culture into detailed discussion, let us try to define the term society in a general way. The term society can be compared with an individual where he has different organs and organ systems, which become functional only when each and every organ of the body coordinates in a well-mannered system. This functionality continues until the death of the individual. Likewise, a society constitutes of group of individuals who correspond to different roles and responsibilities, taking different positions and duties. Unlike an individual body, society remains functional and continues for generations by the random roles and behaviors of the people through the systematic process of procreation and orientation. The coordination of different individuals as per the norms established by the members of society. Different societies have different rules and regulations depending upon the nature of social structure. Social structures are the social facts and components or the principles in which a society is organized. A.R. Radcliffe Brown, the social anthropologist, 1881-1955, defines the components of social structure as human beings, which are institutionally regulated by organizing individuals in different roles and relationships. Therefore, understanding social structure means one has to follow the prescribed social relations and norms as per the established rules found in various institutions of the society. Is society dynamic? Every society has its own structure, which keeps on continuing from one generation to another generation, and thus the nature of society varies accordingly. Besides the varied nature of structure among the societies, it is also found within the society. The dynamic nature of society can be explained by our own social system, such as family, marriage, caste system, etc. The basic unit of Indian social system is family, and the structure of family varies from one community to another, from one generation to another generation. As for example, there used to be a rigid form of joint family structure, especially in the Hindu society, which is now changing to such an extent that almost all of us belong to nuclear or extended forms of family. These are nothing but the product of individuals and its role relationships. Likewise, the forms of marriage or caste system found in any society is changing from time to time, and this has resulted into a changed nature of society. Thus, society is not static but dynamic in nature and function. There are various forms of society found in the social structure of an area based on the level of technology used. Mention may be made of the hunter-gatherers, pastoralists, horticulturalists, agriculturalists, and industrialists. Now, let us see the concept of culture. We have discussed the structure and forms of society in relation with definitions provided by different anthropologists and sociologists. However, understanding a society and its structure is not possible unless we are clear about the concept of culture, which remains as the constituents of social structure. Some of the selected definitions given by different scholars are: E.V. Tyler, the father of anthropology, defined culture as that complex whole which includes knowledge, belief, art, law, morals, customs, and any other capabilities acquired by man as a member of society. According to Herskovitz, culture is the man-made part of the environment. Kissing, another renowned cultural anthropologist, explained it as totality of learned socially transmitted behavior. The above mentioned definitions have included various facets of understanding the term culture. Tyler's definition of culture includes the manifestation of our shared beliefs, morals, values, and ideas into several norms and patterns passing through generations. His complex whole includes the very intricate units of man and his works, thought processes, and behaviors that include both tangible and intangible characteristics of culture. These are the product of the abilities and proficiencies of men who remain as a member of society. One who lives in groups or organizations to continue the process of adaptation and existence. So, the most important point to remember is the learned behavior of human beings. Every society has its own culture based on the nature of structure, geographical environment, and population relating it to certain norms and rules. These norms and rules allow performing roles and responsibilities in the society and relating it with other societies. In order to have a successful understanding and functionality of a society, we need to know the components or structure of culture. The aspect of culture can be differentiated into real or ideal, material or non-material, of which the smallest unit of it is called culture trait. According to Crover, it's been considered as minimally definable element of culture. Let us take an example of a classroom where you have table, chair, benches, desk, blackboard, chalk, duster, and students. Each of these is considered as culture trait, as each of them gives a minimally definable or functional element in the classroom composition. However, in case one of the legs of the table is broken and becomes non-functional, then the table cannot be considered as a trait since it failed to act as a single minimally definable functional unit. Thus, table in the classroom becomes a culture trait only when it acts as a functional unit which is real and observable. Now, if we combine two or more culture traits and represent it into a functional network of relationships, then it is called culture complex. In the example, the classroom itself is the representation of culture complex where more than one cultural trait combines and become functional for the deliberation of lectures or classroom teachings. Such web of relations establishes coordination in various institutions of the society. These cultural components are expressed in the form of cultural patterns and behaviors in different culture areas. Is culture dynamic? When we understood the dynamicity of society, it is imperative to arrive into the conclusion that culture is not static but dynamic in nature. All society performs its role in accordance with the cultural norms, values, and practices involved. The roles and responsibilities of different institutions in a society are governed in relation with values, beliefs, worldviews, ideas, folkways, and mores, and notice lots of diversity in different cultural traits and complexes. To conclude, the above mentioned points so that understanding mankind and its developmental procedures provide an intimate relationship of network of social relations and systems which are bound in the social structure of a society. Each society has its own social systems which are expressed and functional based on the cultural norms, values, and practices. The conceptual understanding of society and culture provides the involved relationship of these two terms and can be considered as both sides of a coin.